Welcome back to the Razor Crest series, and in this part we're going to go over how to load in a VDB inside a vray volume grid. This is going to be the same methodology for loading in sequences, but in this video I'm just going to be showing you how to load in clouds. Now check the link in the description or where you can access some clouds. The one I'm going to show you in the video, I'll try to find that one as well and link to that. But Embergen, which is some software we'll be previewing later, just released a whole bunch of VDB sequences for clouds, which look pretty cool, so you might be interested in using those instead. All right, let's get started. Okay, so what I'd like to show you now is what a render layer is. But in order for this to make more sense, we really need a little bit more of a complex scene. On Canvas, there is a cloud VDB, and a VDB is a volumetric file, and it's called High Altitude Big Cloud Flat 14. This is from a cloud pack, but this was their free one just to see if you liked their stuff, and it's a really good use of a VDB. So instead of having to simulate clouds or use clouds only as an image, you could load in a VDB of a cloud, and you can get volumetric clouds very easily inside of vray. So in order to use that, what we're going to do, we're going to go up to vray, and then we're going to go to volume grid. I'm going to say volume grid. Basically gives you a stock bounding box. And this is also related to PhoenixFD, but you can use this just with vray. So under input, where it says preview and render path, click on the dots there, go to browse. And I would recommend saving that file in your assets folder. Really, you can save it wherever you want, but just keep your project folder organized. I'm going to have that in assets, double click. And then right away, it's going to say, hey, what do you want to do with this? Where did this come from? And if you don't know, doesn't matter. Just say no preset. Doesn't matter. So by default, it's going to preview the cloud in the viewport. And this is fairly large, pretty cool. And then to move this around, we can simply just move it like we would any old object. And it's really cool. So to see what we've got, we can go to the viewport IPR for vray. And we got a really, really dark cloud. So to fix that, we can go down to rendering, and then we can go down to smoke color. This is considered smoke. I'm going to crank up the color all the way up to the maximum value there. And when we do that, nothing changes because unfortunately, changes to VDBs, either their transform or their color doesn't really update. So we do have to keep refreshing it, which is kind of annoying. And it's a little bit more annoying to do that in the viewport. So I'm going to open back up the IPR. We can go to the vray frame buffer and we'll just do it here. So we can rotate around and we can kind of see where those clouds are. So this is going to be a little bit tricky to see. And I actually want to change the lighting a little bit. I want something a little bit more interesting to look at. I'm going to take this sun. I'm going to move it back here. Do something more like evening. We get some nice highlights on the ship, something more like that. And then that's going to make our clouds kind of orangey, kind of picking up some of that reflection of the sun. Honestly, though, they look like storm clouds. So to change the thickness of them, we can select our VDB again, go down to smoke opacity. We have a color slider, so you can change the color slider. Go back to startup IPR again. And at white, it's going to be very, very thin and wispy. If we back that down a little bit, we can see we get the clouds back again. This is just going to be kind of a game going back and forth just to see, you know, what difference that we get. You can also just go down to the simple smoke opacity here. You could do something like 1. And this is going to be really, really thick. Kind of ridiculously thick. It's like an explosion's gone off. Or you could do something really, really thin and wispy, like 0.1. Something kind of like that. So it really just depends on what kind of clouds that you'd like to do. And using the constant color here and the simple opacity, they kind of counter each other. So you can use both of them, but if you just wanted to use one or the other, that's fine too. I personally think the smoke opacity is a little bit easier to work with than the constant color. This is very useful though if you have a texture and you want to kind of paste texture over everything. It's kind of useful to do that. So I want this smoke to be a little bit more dense. And unfortunately, we just have to keep stopping the IPR and going back. But we can do something like that. If we don't like the color, we can change it later. We can do some color correction of that in post. Okay, so what I'd like to do now is kind of just make a scene that looks interesting. So I'm just going to hold down the shift key there, kind of drag that out, drag out a copy of this. We're just going to make some interesting clouds. And I want to get rid of this grid. I'm going to get rid of that by clicking the grid icon. And I want to pull another one of these down underneath. So these files are great. There's a lot of things that you can do with these VDBs, and you can actually make it look like there's a lot more like variation of clouds, even just using the same VDB over and over and over again. So really we should be instancing these, but we're not, but it's fine. Doesn't really matter for this. It's not going to be super heavy. Once we have something that we're happy with, we can begin setting up our render layers. Let's see what we have here. So it always looks way thicker in the viewport than it does actually in the IPR mode. So I'm going to pull this under here, just add a little bit more depth there. Back to the viewport IPR. You can use this or you can use the other IPR. It doesn't really matter. It's whatever you prefer. And on some of these, I actually would like to make these a little bit thicker. Change that to 0.5. Makes those a little bit thicker there. And I think I'm going to do the same thing on these as well. So something like this is going to be pretty interesting. Thanks for watching. In the next part, we're going to go over how to set up your V-Ray cameras. And specifically, we're going to be talking about focal lengths and the focal lengths that are going to be appropriate for an aerial aviation shot such as this. If you're interested, see you guys in the next video.